Morning students, so today we will continue with the remaining portion of our geography first chapter, that is distributional maps. And now today we are going to study about geographical field visit. You have studied it in your earlier classes also. Field visit, it is generally carried out to collect information of a region by actually visiting a place. Not just sitting in front of a computer or a laptop and collecting information of that region. In a field visit, you have to personally go to that region and then you will collect the information of that particular region by actually visiting that place, by actually seeing that place, by actually talking with the people of that region. You are going to collect the information. So, see page number 6, geographical field visit. Field visit is an important study method in geography. Geographical concepts and elements can be directly experienced through field visit. Field visits are extremely useful for understanding the correlation between humans and environment. That this field visit is for the correlation between the human and environment. That how the human being is dependent on the environment. What is the correlation? What is the bonding of the human and the environment? So when you will go to that particular place, then only you will come to know that what is the relation between the human being and the environment. So before going to do a field visit, you have to make some preparations. The preparations for a field visit. First, what you have to do? First, you have to decide the place. First, you have to decide the region. That which region you are going to visit, which place you are going to visit. And then, what is the purpose of your visit? What is the aim of your visit? What you will go, what you are going to do there? Which activities you have to take? So that thing you have to decide in advance. So before going to the field visit, decide the place and the purpose of the visit. The elements which will be observed in field visit should be decided. Study the location map and the route map of the place to be visited. That when you don't know that place, you have not visited that place. So you have to study the location. You have to study the map, you have to study the route map, and then according to that you will go for your field visit. Distance, transport route, means of transport and duration of field visit should be planned ahead. Distance means the distance ki aap jahan pe rehte hain wahan se wo jagah kitni duri par hai. The distance should be measured. Then transport route, which means of transport you are going to take, which transport routes are available to that region, then accordingly you will decide the transport route. Then the duration of your field visit, that what is the duration of your field visit? It is 1 day, maybe 6 hours, whatever. So that duration you have to calculate earlier. Then with the help of a teacher, students, you should prepare a questionnaire. That which questions you are going to ask there. What type of questions you will going to ask that you will visit to that place. Then you will ask to the people of that region that how much population is there, how much literate population is there, how many children are there, how many old age are there, which river is there, which mountain is there, which type of soil is there, what is the type of the road, whether it is a kaccha road or a pakka road, what are the type of the houses over there, kaccha houses or a pakka houses, and then all these things, what is the physiography over there. So these are the questionnaire, these are the list of the questions which you have to prepare in advance before going for a field visit. Then a selection of the study area is there. That geographical field visit is organized for study of various elements like physical landform, river banks, dams, coastal areas, tourism sites, offices or museums related to geographical elements, villages, forest areas, etc. Elements should be selected after studying the local conditions and necessary permission letters have to be obtained. The first important thing before going for a field visit is that you have to take out a permission from a concerned office that you your teacher and so many students you are going to visit this particular location, this particular region, and then when the permission is granted to you, then only you can go for your field visit. So the first important thing for a field visit is that you have to seek a permission of a concerned officer, and while taking out the permission, you have to give him the detailed information that what is the purpose of your visit, why you are going in that region for a field visit, how many students you are there, who is there with you, who will accompany you, which mode of transport you are going to take. All these are the questions which the officers is going to inquire, and then only he will grant you a permission. Then some necessary articles you should carry for a field visit, they are, you should carry a notebook, specimen questionnaire, as I told you that a list of the questions you have to prepare. Then pen, pencil, scale, tape, compass, a bag for collecting samples, that sample of a soil, sample of the trees. So the samples, to collect those samples, you have to carry with you the sample bags. Then map, camera, and so many things etc. are there which you can carry for a field visit. Then precautions should be taken during a field visit, that it is very important to ensure safety of ourselves and others during a field visit, that you do not cause harm to you and to others also. Then you should take in mind, you should take precaution that you don't harm the environment over there. You should obey the instructions given by the teachers. You should not go to unknown remote places alone, because that region is not known to you. That region is totally unknown to you. So you should not leave the group which are assigned to you, the group which your teacher has assigned to you. You should be in that groups only. You should not go alone to any other place. Then first prior thing you should keep in mind, that don't cause any harm to the environmental conditions of that region. Then during field visit, you should try to understand the local circumstances by conversing with the local people over there, that how they reside there, what is the day-to-day activity they take on in that region. So these local circumstances you should come to know when you visit to that particular region. Then you should also ensure that you do not harm the environment in any way during your visit. You should always keep a first aid box with you for emergency circumstances. That first aid box should always be there when you are going for a field visit. Then after your field visit is over, what you have to do? You have to file a report. Then first is the field visit, then is the selection of a region. After selecting a region, when you go actually to that place, you collect the information. Then the precautions, as I told you, that precautions you have to be take, that precautions you should take. Then after all this, your field visit is over, you have to make a report. A field report should be written on the basis of the information obtained after the field visit is complete. That when your field visit is complete, you will make a report, and that report will be on the basis of the information gathered, that whatever information you have collected during your field visit. So on the basis of that information, you are going to make your report. Then the following issues you should take into consideration while making a report, and then you should add photographs wherever it is necessary, as you have carried the camera with you. So that camera was for the purpose to take out the photograph and then to paste when you will make a report. So in the first point in your report writing will be introduction. Your introduction, introduction of a region which you have visited. Then the location map and a route map, that where it is located, which route you have taken. Then you are going to paste a location map and a route map. After that, the physiography of that region, that what was the physiography, was there any land, what was type of a land over there, what was the mountain over there, how greenery was there. Then climate, and then population. In population there will be male population, female population, old age population, children population, then literate population, illiterate population. So this is how you are going to make the table of a population. Then the environmental problems and the measures to overcome them. That what was the environmental problem in that particular region and how you can overcome the problem over there. What measures we should take so that we can rescue the environmental conditions over there. We can overcome to the environmental conditions over there. Environmental problems which are there in that region, how we can solve them. So the measures you have to suggest. Then the land utilization, that what is the land utilized over there? Is it utilized for farming? Is it utilized for an industrial purpose? So this kind of the land, what kind of the land utilization is there, that you have to mention. And after that, you should come to the conclusion, that what conclusion after making a field visit, what you think is should be done. So the last point in a report writing is the conclusion. So this is was all about your field visit. That field visit, it is collecting information of a region by actually visiting a place. Then after your field visit is complete, whatever information you have gathered, on the basis of that information you have to make a report, and the points are given there. According to that points you are going to file your report. So with this, student, we have completed our first chapter. You go through the chapter. If you have any problem, you can ask me. Then we will continue with the question answers when we will meet.